You're from Scotland. Tell us about that.
I'm from a place called Livingston. Not many people have heard of it. Born there and then grew up in a little village called Balerno. Again, not many people have heard of it. It is, it's just a little village. It has a post office, it has a shop, has a Chinese takeaway. That's it, really. But it was a great place to grow up. Yeah.
How long were you there for before you left?
I moved to London when I was 17.
By yourself?
By myself. Which is a bit weird now when I look back. I'm like, why did I think that was a good thing to do? I mean, it was, but I was like, yeah, I'm moving to London. And my mum was like, no, what are you doing?
How did that go about? Like, how do you have these conversations saying, okay, now it's time, I'm going to go? Like, that's a whole other country away.
Yeah. I think because my career had sort of started kicking off, and I think my parents were like, okay, like, this is the right thing for you to do. They were never the type of parents who were like, you need to go to university, you need to do this. They were like, just do what makes you happy, which is, I'm so grateful for. But yeah, it's not too far. So she kept an eye on me.
True,
but
true.
I don't know, you feel so old at that age, I think.
I think so.
Yeah.
And when you're looking back, you're like, I was so young. But
yeah.
At 17, I thought I was the boss of my own life.
Uh-huh. I was really lucky to get a publishing deal when I was 17. So that means like publishers are who publish songwriters. I don't know if I'm explaining that very well, if people don't know. But I got a deal for my songwriting, not a record deal, songwriting one. So that gave me like an opportunity to move, because it was so hard to move from Scotland to London, because London's obviously so expensive. And my manager was like, you can have my sofa bed like in the spare room for a year. So I had that, and then I was able to do music full time. So I was just writing every day until I had like an EP or whatever.
So tell us about this small town. When did you decide to pick up the guitar, or was that your first instrument?
So I had a keyboard, like a little Casio keyboard in my house, and I played like triads. And then when I was 15, I heard Taylor Swift, and I was like, I want to do that. I loved singing. I always used to sing in my living room, my little karaoke machine. And, you know, I'd sing like Britney, Christina, Whitney Houston. Oh, I'd try and sing Whitney Houston. Like all the greats. And I guess like I'm not an actual mover, but I'm an actual writer. Like I'd write poems and stuff like that. And I've always kind of had a thing for words and stories. So when I heard Taylor Swift, I was like, yeah, this is what I want to do. And so then I picked up a guitar and learned all her songs. And then through that, learned chords, I guess, and taught myself how to write songs.
Do you remember the first song you learned fully through the guitar and like being able to perform and play at the same time, which is not an easy task at all?
I think it was Love Story.
Okay.
But I didn't quite nail the guitar part. I think it was like a very simple version of Love Story. But yeah, that was the one that I was like, oh, it's like, a young girl can play an instrument and write her own songs. Like, that's cool. I didn't know that was even a thing.
So do you think Taylor Swift is a musical influence, or do you have a different musical influence?
Yeah, definitely. I think from day one, like, she was a musical influence of mine. And then, like, people like Alanis Morissette, I love how kind of like unfiltered her lyrics are. She just she'll say things that everyone's thinking, but is like too scared to say. Do you know what I mean?
Yes, definitely.
And when I heard Jagged Little Pill, my manager put me onto it when I was maybe 19. I think I was going through a breakup, and she was like, you need this album. And I was like, oh, she's saying everything I want to say. And that kind of, that inspired actually the first song I'm going to play today, a song called The Best You Had, where it's kind of saying, you know, it's like an ugly thing to be jealous, right? But everyone gets it, especially when your ex like gets someone new or whatever. And I was
fast
like,
fast too.
Alanis has nailed it with that. So yeah, I have a lot of inspirations, but she's definitely a big one.
Do you remember the first album you maybe purchased?
What I loved Dido when I was younger. It was when like White Flag and all that were out, and it was my mum's birthday coming up, and my dad was like, what do you think mum would want for her birthday? And I was like, she loves Dido, she'll want the Dido album, because I knew that's the only way I could get the album. And my mum was like, I don't even like Dido, where have you got this?
So let's get into a couple of songs. Do you want to play something for us?
Yeah.
What are you going to play first?
We're going to start with a song called The Best You Had, which is the one I was describing earlier. Alanis was a huge influence for this. And yeah.
Awesome.
Take it away.
Does she ever feel like me? Run her fingers down your back. Do you ever talk about us? Or is it just the bad times we had? Cause baby, it's been 3 weeks and I'm going on my mind. How does she taste? Is it sweeter than mine was? I've been using bodies just to get me through the night. Is it the same, huh? Cause it's crazy that you're moving on so fast. But baby, it's okay if I'm still the best you had. And it hurts that you would just leave like that. But baby, it's okay if I'm still the best you had. Nobody did it like us, nobody did it like you did. Darling, I know that we're dumb, but you know me, girl, it's stupid. Tell everyone I hate her, cause I'm scared of how you feel. It's complicated, cause it's crazy that you're moving on so fast. But baby, it's okay if I'm still the best you had. And it hurts to think about you like that. But baby, it's okay if I'm still the best you had. Oh na 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 na. Oh na 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 na. If I'm still the best you had. Na 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 na. Oh na 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 na. Oh na 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 na. If I'm still the best you had. And I don't want you. No, nothing more. I don't need you. Whoa. It's crazy that you're moving on so fast. When I'm still the best you had. It's crazy that you're moving on so fast. But baby, it's okay if I'm still the best you had. And it hurts that you would just leave like that. But baby, it's okay if I'm still the best you had. Oh, it hurts. Oh, oh, oh. Just tell me I'm still the best you had.
That was amazing.
Oh, thank you.
Wow. What was the process like writing this song?
It was actually like the weirdest song to write because I had the chorus lyric that it's crazy you're moving on so fast, but baby it's okay if I'm still the best you had in my notes for like 6 months. And I was like, I love that little couplet. And I wrote the song 3 times, like completely different songs, but with that lyric, because I was like, I just want to get this lyric in a song. And I was like, nah, they're not cutting it, they're not good enough. And then I went into the studio with my friend Jordan Riley, who's a great producer and writer, and he just started playing the chords, and then it literally just came out, like the whole song just came out within 20 minutes. And yeah, it was really cool to write. We used like, you know, like hard auto-tune setting on a microphone to get all the melodies, because mm-hmm. it's very like, goes right up there. So it was a really cool way of writing it. But yeah, it just kind of came out.
Your next song is your latest single.
It is, yeah.
Life's a Bitch.
Life's a Bitch.
You want to just jump right on into that?
Yeah, this is Life's a Bitch.
Got the keys of cars on the sheet, feels like a marathon. You got your left hand on my knee, you're spitting bars and hip-hop beats. Crash your speakers in your room, yeah, switch your TV off the news. My phone is going dead again. Won't you come to bed and then I'll say I'm not romantic. Think love is too dramatic, how we fell for one another. I still don't understand it, I'm just waiting for the summer. The darkness to be overcome to think life's like a bitch. I hate her, but I love her. I'm with you through these lows and highs. but I don't let it, no. I don't let it get me down. I don't let it, no. I don't let it get me down. I don't let it, no. I don't let it get me down. Life's like a bitch, I hate her, but I love her. Turning up to posh fence when we were friends of benefits, was struggling to pay the rent. Now I drive a Mercedes Benz. Easy days and lucid nights. I don't do drugs and I don't fight. I care too much and not enough. Leo moon and Cancer sun. My astrological placement tells me that I'm so amazing. You say that I drive you crazy. That's 'cause you're from the 80s. Marijuana on the sofa. Smoke too much, got paranoid. Wish you were some. Life's a bitch, I hate her, but I love her. I'm with you through these lows and highs. Ain't it cruel how it hurts sometimes? But I don't let it, no. I don't let it get me down. I don't let it, no. I don't let it get me down. I don't let it. I don't let it get me down. Life's like a bitch, I hate her, but I love her. Raise a glass and take a shot, we'll do it for the hell of it. Life is good until it's not, and there's no way of telling it. Raise a glass and take a shot, we'll do it for the hell of it. Life is good until it's not, and there's no way of telling it. And I don't let it, I don't let it get me down. I don't let it, no. I don't let it get me down. I don't let it, no. I don't let it get me down. Life's like a bitch, I hate her, but I love her.
Life's like a bitch. Thank you for that.
Thank you.
So when you're writing songs, do you do the lyrics first, or do you do the sound and like the instruments first?
It really depends on. Every song is completely different, how it comes out. But I normally just like to find some chords, and then I just set up a microphone and sing until something good comes out. And I think, like, this is quite a horrible quote, but I think it's quite a good one. My boyfriend always says, songwriting is a lot like farting. If you have to force it, it's probably shit. Which is so true, right?
That's very, very true.
It should naturally come out. So I like to just feel it.
When you're writing songs, like, have you ever written a song that you like, I have it in mind for X, Y artist, and then you get through it and you're like, that actually might be a really good Nina Nesbitt song.
Yeah, definitely. I feel like they're the best ones because I'm not overthinking it, and I'm not thinking, what would I say? Like, what do I sound like? And I love just going into a room for a day and being like, I'm going to write a song that Rihanna would sing, or just like dreaming someone up that I love and that inspires me. And just, it's like a kind of fresh, it's like if I've got writer's block, I'll do that because it kind of just flips my mindset. And sometimes I just get something new. But yeah, there's a lot of songs on the last album, like Is It Really Me You're Missing, a song called Somebody Special. I wrote that with Selena Gomez in mind. Like, I'll pick like someone that I like at the time and just.
Do we have time for some songs?
Yeah, we do. Yeah, we're actually going to cover a Taylor Swift song.
Awesome, which song?
It's a song called I Almost Do. I've never sung this before. If I forget the words, I'm sorry. I will make them up. Apologies in advance. But yeah, this is one of my favourite. She's re-releasing Red, I think, is it this Friday?
This Friday.
And there's a 10-minute version of All Too Well. Oh, my God.
We already discussed this.
I can't. But this is one of my favourite songs that I feel like is a hidden gem. And it's called I Almost Do.
I bet this time tonight you're still up. I bet you're tired from a long, hard week. And I bet you're sitting in your chair by the window, looking out at the city. And I bet sometimes you think about me. And I just wanna tell you, It takes everything in me not to call you. And I just wanna run to you, and I hope you know that every time I don't, I almost do. I bet you think I either moved on or hate you. Cause each time you reach out, the snow will fly. And I bet it never ever occurred to you that I can't say hello to you and risk another goodbye. And I just wanna tell you, it takes everything in me not to call you. And I just wanna run to you, and I hope you know that every time I don't, I almost do, I almost do. We made quite a mess, babe. It's probably better off this way. And I confess, baby, in my dreams I'm touching your face, asking me if I wanna try again. And I, oh, I almost do. Cause I wish I could tell you, it takes everything in me not to call you. And I wish I could run to you, and I hope you know that every time I don't, I almost do, I almost do. You're tired from a long, hard week. And I bet you're sitting in your chair by the window, looking out at the city, and I hope sometimes you wonder about me.
You and Taylor Swift go way back, right? So you said that she was a musical influence for you, yeah. Hearing a singer-songwriter of your generation and saying, oh, I can do this. Mm-hmm. Then full circle moment, she's co-signing your playlist. So what's that about? You started curating a playlist?
Oh yeah, she put me on her playlist. Yeah.
How did that feel?
She put me on her playlist twice. Can you believe that?
How was it the first time you heard?
I couldn't believe it was real. I just kept, my Twitter was exploding and I was like, oh God, what have I done? And then I was like, oh, it's Taylor Swift. How cool. Yeah, she put me on her playlist and then she sent me a cardigan.
What color?
Like a beige one for folklore.
Oh wow.
Yeah. It was great.
Mine got lost in the mail.
Oh. So you can borrow mine anytime.
You could just bring yours on over, I'll borrow that. So have you guys ever had a conversation? Like have you guys talked about making new music together potentially?
Oh no. I met her once and I kinda like launched myself on her and was like, I love you. It was a long time ago. It was quite embarrassing. But yeah, no, she mentioned me in her speech as well at
the Billboard
Music Awards. So I'm here. I'm here for a collab anytime.
Listen, she championed you. She said that the wave of new talent to listen to, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, she did.
So
cool.
I think we have room for one more song. Yeah. Y'all have something?
Let's do it. This song's actually inspired by Destiny's Child. Who we discussed earlier, and this one's called Loyal to Me, and this is basically about all the warning signs and symptoms that you need to look out for when you fear you may be dating a fuckboy.
Ooh, you heard it here first.
Mm-hmm. of our skulls. We're in and out of love, we're vulnerable. Oh, but we tell you that we're tough. Some of these guys never think they could call, think that we're blind. But they're forgetting that we talk. If he never calls when he says he will, if he always tells you to keep it chill, if you see him out with another girl, baby, then you know he was never real. If he never wants you to meet his friends, if he ain't tagging you on the gram, take you all the time around while you still can. And tell him, tell him, tell him, tell him I got somewhere else to be. And I don't lose my head for nobody. If you have to question, is he loyal to me? Well, then he's probably not, and you should probably leave. Says he's online, oh, but he told you he's asleep. You stay inside, like he never wants you to be seen. Ain't got a doubt, no. Says he models on the side, swears you're the one. Oh, but he's not the label type. If he never calls when he says he will, if he always tells you to keep it chill, if you see him out with another girl, baby, then you know he was never real. Hope you never let those pictures send. He'll only go show them to his friends. Take your heart and turn around while you still can. And tell him, tell him, tell him, tell him I got somewhere else to be. And I don't lose my head for nobody. If you have to question, is he loyal to me? Well, then he's probably not, and you should probably leave. Yeah,
probably leave.